Getting to Know the World's Greatest Artists, Picasso, written and illustrated by Mike Venezia. Pablo Picasso was one of the greatest artists of the 20th century. He was born in Malaga, Spain, in 1881 and died in France in 1973. Picasso's father was an art teacher at the local school. He encouraged his son to paint and draw. He wanted Picasso to become a great artist someday.
"I think we have a great artist on our hands."
"I think we have a great mess on our hands."
Picasso's painting style changed over the period of his life more than any other great artist. He was always trying new and different things. The painting you see was done when he was only 15 years old. This painting was done when Picasso was 57. There's quite a difference between the two paintings, isn't there? Sometimes Picasso would paint things that looked very flat. Sometimes he would paint things that looked so round that you might be able to pick them up off the painting. When Picasso was 19, he left Spain and went to Paris, France. Some of the first paintings he did there look a little bit like the work of other famous French artists. This painting reminds many people of the work done by Toulouse-Lautrec. Some of Picasso's other early paintings remind people of Van Gogh and Gauguin and Monet. The Blue Period. Then something happened. Picasso's paintings changed. His work became different from anyone else's. His best friend died, and Picasso felt alone and sad. At the same time, none of his paintings were selling, and he was almost starving to death. Because of his mood, Picasso began to paint with lots of blue. Blue can be a very sad color. He made all the people in his paintings look lonely and sad. Some people thought Picasso's blue paintings were great. Others, including Picasso's father, thought they were just too strange. This meant his paintings were controversial. The Rose Period. Picasso's blue period ended when he met a girl named Fernande. Fernande and Picasso fell in love, and soon a happier color started showing up in Picasso's paintings. This was the beginning of the Rose Period. Not only were Picasso's colors happier during the Rose Period, but he started painting happier things. Picasso painted a lot of circus people during this time. He often painted them with their animals. The Rose Period didn't last very long, though, because Picasso found a new way to paint that was really exciting and different. Cubism. Cubism was the next style of painting that Picasso developed and made famous. This is a cubist painting of one of Picasso's friends. The man in the painting looks like he's been broken up into little cubes. That's where the name cubism came from. Look closely. Can you see the man's face? What he was wearing? His hands? A bottle? A glass? And maybe his pet cat? Can you find anything else? Cubism is one of the most important periods in the history of modern art. For hundreds of years, artists tried very hard to paint things so that they would look real. Then Picasso came along and started to paint people and things that didn't look the way people and things were supposed to look. Picasso was always shocking people, but when he started painting people who had eyes and noses in the wrong places, well, even some of his closest friends thought he had gone too far. Picasso kept working with cubism and changed it over the years. It became much more colorful and flatter looking. It also became easier to see what Picasso was painting. In the painting, Three Musicians, you can see the three musicians and tell what instruments they're playing. In another style that popped up for a while, Picasso painted people who looked more real again. Picasso had just visited Rome, a city filled with statues and monuments. When he returned from his trip, he did a series of paintings in which people looked like they've been chiseled out of stone, like statues. Guernica. In 1937, something happened that made Picasso paint his most powerful and serious painting. During a civil war that was going on in Spain, the small town of Guernica was destroyed by bombs. Thousands of innocent people were killed or injured. Picasso became very angry and used everything he knew to make a painting that would show the world how foolish war was. He named the painting after the town that was destroyed. Picasso used darker colors, cubism, and lots of expression to get his angry feelings across in this painting. He also used size. This painting is huge. It's 12 feet high and 25 feet wide. Many of Picasso's paintings look funny because of the way he moves eyes, noses, and chins around. The amazing thing about these paintings is how much they look like the real person. Look at the painting of Picasso's best friend, Jaime Sabartés, on the opposite page. Does it look like the same man shown in the painting below? The thing that made Picasso such a great artist was his originality. He had the imagination to try new and different things through his entire life. Picasso lived to be 92 years old. He was a great painter, but he was great at other things too. He made sculptures, prints, drawings, beautifully colored dishes and bowls. He even made costumes and scenery for plays. It's a lot of fun to see real Picasso paintings. You'll be surprised at how big some of them are. Look for his paintings in your art museum. The pictures in this book came from the museums listed below. If none of these museums is close to you, maybe you can visit one when you are on vacation. Abadía de Montserrat, Barcelona, Spain. Museum of Modern Art, New York, New York. Solomon Guggenheim Museum in New York City, New York. The Art Institute, Chicago, Illinois. National Gallery of Art, Washington, D.C., Museo del Prado, Madrid, Spain, Picasso Museum, Barcelona, Spain, Musée Picasso, Paris, France.